Okay, hello friends, welcome to another video from Shomu's Biology. And today's lecture we are going to talk about arthropods. Okay, so let me write it here, arthropods or arthropoda. This phylum, phylum arthropoda. Okay, so let me make this slide a little smaller. Fine. Okay, so let's talk about arthropods. Okay, so arthropoda phylum, what we want to talk about, the very first thing I'm going to talk about is characteristics. Then I'll also going to talk a little bit about their classification or types. Then I'll also talk about their reproduction. Okay, these are the three things that we want to talk about, and obviously example of arthropods. In the classification we'll also talk about examples of different arthropods. So the very first thing about characteristics of arthropods. Okay, so let me talk about the general characteristics as well as some key features that arthropods only have. The general characteristics, if we talk about it, we can say that they have organ and organ system in their body, right? And arthropods are much evolved compared to the platyhelminths, aschelminths, all these things. So they have bilateral symmetry in their body, and they are also triploblastic animal means they have ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, three different germ layers. And the other things we can say is that their body is actually segmented into three different parts: head, thorax, abdomen. Now, one thing I want to clear first here is that most of the people, when we say arthropod, actually think about insects, right? But arthropod does not only mean insect, it means insects. Insect is a type of arthropods, but apart from insects, there are other examples of arthropod, crustaceans, for example. So there are different examples of arthropods that are available, and not all of them have the same kind of structures, but all of them has a feature which is known as, you know, they have a, what I can say, jointed legs. Okay, this is a very common feature among all arthropods, but not all of them share other common features. The other organ system I am going to talk about is regarding the circulatory system. Okay, so they have an open circulatory system, open circulation. Okay, now this is unique because, you know, in annelida, example is earthworm has a closed circulatory system, but arthropods have open circulatory system. Okay, the respiratory organs, the respiration, if you think about respiration is done using what kind of organs? It's done using gills. Okay, it's done using other things like book gills or book lungs. Okay, all these things. And they have sensory organ. They also obviously have sensory organs presence in their body. Sensory organ is present. Okay, these are the important features. And other, so sensory organ means they have eyes, they have antenna, all these things. Their eyes, compound eye. Okay, and there are some examples where they have simple eye as well. Excretory system, if we talk about excretion is done using malpighian tube is the excretory organ which is used by arthropods. Okay, now what about the cytoskeleton? So they have exoskeleton system. Okay, and this is another very common feature. Let me write, they have exoskeleton system, which is mostly made up with what? Protein and a little bit of lipids. So they are mostly made up with protein. Let me write it, mostly made up with protein. An example of such is chitin, C-H-I-T-I-N. Okay, chitin. So when, you know, in different places of the world, people eat insects. Okay, and when you eat insect, you're literally eating a high protein content because their whole exoskeleton structure is made up with entirely proteins like chitin. Okay, so this is an idea about the characteristics. But remember, this jointed legs and exoskeleton are very common feature that are present in all types of arthropods. But we are going to talk about the different classification schemes. So I am going to break them down into four different portions actually. Let me write them down. One is the example where they have two pairs of antenna. Okay, so let me write two pairs of antenna and five or more pair of legs. So if that is the situation, then they are known as crustaceans. Okay, so let me write it. They are known as crustaceans. Example, shrimp, prawn, right? So let me write them down. Example, shrimps. Okay. Now, the other example, if I am going to talk about, they have three pairs of legs and one or two pair of wings. Now, this is a typical example of what? Insects, isn't it? Insects. And what is the example? Example is butterfly, moth, praying mantis, all this. Okay. Let me write butterfly as an example. Then what we have another type. There is no antenna, but four pair of legs. And the example in this case, spiders. If you recall, they have eight legs, four pair of legs. Spiders, totally different. And then there are some other example where they have many pairs of leg, segmented body with legs. Example, centipedes and millipedes. Okay, these are examples. So these are all the different types of arthropods, but the common feature that they have is that they all have jointed legs and they have a hard skeleton, the exoskeleton, and mostly made up with proteins. This is common to all of them. Okay, so the biggest phylum of the invertebrate is the arthropoda. Now, what about their reproduction? How do they reproduce? Okay, what we know is that they have separate sexes, and so that means they have male-female difference, and they have internal fertilization. That means the process of fertilization takes place inside of the body. Other external development is done. So fertilization is internal, development is external. And in external development means start with egg into larva, right? Or we can call it nymph. Then finally pupa stage, and then finally adult. All these stages. And when they form pupa structure, in between they modify themselves in so many different ways. So we call it metamorphosis. Okay, so this is an external development. Internal fertilization followed by external development. This is another characteristics of arthropoda. Okay, so that is all about the arthropoda phylum. So if you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to our channel to get more videos like that in future. Thank you.